road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love is making music with my friends, and I can't wait to get on the road again. On the road again.
Good morning, everybody. It is Erev Shabbat. It is January the 20th, and I am still on the road. Hopefully, I'll get there before Shabbat. Oh, hold on a second. Let's pull over and see who this is. Ah, good morning, Rabbi Hazan. How are you?
Hello, Rabbi B. And hello, Hillel family. I'd like to share with you a short Divrei Torah and lesson from Parashat Vayera. It says in the Parashah, Vayomer Hashem el Moshe, Haved lef paro me'en l'shalach ha'am. Before the Makkah, before the plague of Dam, the first of the 10 plagues is Makkah Dam. Before the plague, Hashem tells Moshe that Paro's heart is very, very hard. Now, what does it mean Paro's heart is very hard? So it's hard, it's stubborn. Paro's stubborn. Now the word kaved also means liver. A liver, if you ever cook liver, you ever eat liver, it's very delicious, very tasty. Liver is fried onions, very good. Liver, what happens is the more it gets cooked, the more it gets roasted, it gets very tough, it gets very hard. So HaKadosh Baruch Hu was telling Moshe that Paro's heart is very hard, very stubborn, very tough. Here's a short mashal. Give us a mashal, there's animals, a group of animals that are walking in the road. And what happened was, They got to a toll. Who was running the toll? A donkey. Donkey was running the toll booth. Now, this group of animals, they had the fox, they had the lion, they had all the animals of the forest. So they get to the toll booth and the donkey says, you gotta pay your toll or else you're not gonna be able to go through. The fox tells the donkey, you gotta pay my toll? Are you joking? We have the lion over here. The lion can eat you up in a second. You don't start up with the lion. And before you know it, the lion pounces on the donkey, knocks him out, eats him, kills him. And then the lion tells the fox, he says, listen, take the donkey and cook him up. We're going to eat him for dinner tonight. So it comes dinner time. And before dinner, the fox decided he wanted to eat the heart of the donkey. So now the lion tells the donkey, tells the fox, he says, where's the heart? I want to eat the heart. The portion that I really like the most. So the fox answers, I'm sorry, he didn't have a heart. So the lion says, what do you mean the donkey didn't have a heart? Joking? The fox says, no, you think he had a heart? How can he possibly have had a heart? You think if he had a heart, he would have started up with you and me and all the big wild animals that are much stronger and bigger than him? So, what's the mishnah? What's the parable? The parable is Paro. You think Paro had a heart? You think Paro, if he would have had a heart, he would have started up with Hashem, with Moshe, with Aaron, who were messengers of Hashem? Absolutely not. Obviously, Paro's heart was tough. It was like a rock. It was stubborn. It was hard. There's nothing there. There's no motion. It's raw. What's the lesson we see from here? The lesson we see from here is that what? We should learn from what? From Paro, not to be like Paro. We have to realize that what? We have to have a heart. We have to realize that who's in charge? Hashem is in charge. We have to use our heart and we have to use our mind to serve Hashem and to love Hashem, to get close to Hashem, and not like what Paro did. Have a beautiful winter break and we miss you.
Well, thanks for that, Rabbi Hazan. Hey, good morning, Rabbi Leon Cohen.
Good morning, Rabbi B. Hello, Hillel Yeshiva. In this week's parasha, Parashat Vayera, which discusses 7 of the 10 plagues, after the fourth plague, or before the fourth plague, the plague of Arab, wild animals, Hashem says, V'samti fedut ben ami u'ben amecha. I will make a distinction. I will place a distinction between my nation and between your nation, the Egyptians. Meaning that Hashem will show the difference between His nation, the Jewish people, by making sure that no wild animals will be present amongst the Jewish people and between the Egyptian nation, where the wild animals will roam and cause destruction. However, Rabbi Yaakov Abu Hatzira says that this is hinting to another distinction. The word Vesamti, Samti, actually stands for the 3 signs that distinguish the Jewish people from the nations of the world. The word Samti is Sin, Mem, Taf, Yod. Which stands, the sin stands with is Shin, is Shabbat. The Mem is Milah. The Taf is Tefillin. And these, the Yod means Yahad, together. These 3, Shabbat, Milah, and Tefillin, distinguish each of us as God's nation. we're now going to be on vacation, we need to remember that this is what makes us the children of the king, the nation of the king. The milah is the stamp of the king on our body. Tefillin is the crown of the king that we wear on our heads. And the Shabbat is God's day that we celebrate to show that we believe God is the king who created the world. So now that we're on vacation, we have to be extra careful to continue to keep those signs. We have to be careful that we put on our tefillin every day. We have to be careful to make sure that we behave properly. And we also have to be very careful to make sure that we keep the Shabbat perfectly. Have a wonderful vacation.
Hope you guys enjoyed that. I'll see you guys a little later. Gotta hit that bell.